The early church was quite a bit different than what most people might think of today when they think of church. Jesus had just gone back up to heaven, and this new thing called the church was just starting. But this new church wasn't a building, it was a group of people. The Bible tells us in Acts 2:42 that they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship and to sharing in meals, including the Lord's Supper, and to prayer. This verse tells us four very important things that this new family of believers were devoted to. These are four things that we should still do today, so let's talk about them. Number one, they were devoted to learning about God from their teachers. Do you know what is so cool? You are doing right now exactly what was important to the followers of Jesus we read about in the Bible. They knew that it was important to listen to the teachers God had put in their lives, and so do you. They were committed to constantly listen to the instructions of their teachers and learn about how they could become more and more like Jesus. We see in God's Word that it is so important that we commit to go to where we can hear teachings about God so that we can grow in spiritual strength. Number two, they spent time with other followers of Jesus. Of course, we want to show God's love to everyone around us, but the Bible teaches us how important it is to have friends who are also followers of Jesus. These are the kind of friends that encourage us to live for Jesus. We want to seek out friends that help point us to Jesus throughout the day and also help us turn away from things that we know are sin. And we should do the same for them. So who do you spend your time with every day? Do you have friends who follow Jesus with their whole heart and help you do the same? We see in the Bible that spending time with others who follow Jesus helps us live strong for Him. Number three, they shared meals and basically everything else. The followers of Jesus were committed to not only sharing meals together, but also sharing everything with each other. They did not consider anything they had to be only their own. Instead, they considered whatever they owned to belong to the whole group. There was no, hey, this is mine, get your own. Quite the opposite. They lived so unselfishly. In fact, if they saw a need of someone around them and they didn't have what that person needed, they would sell something they owned so they could share the money that they made with those in need. Wow, I can tell you that is not the way just anyone in our world acts. It's really more natural for people to hold tightly onto their possessions and their money. It's not always natural to say, God, I know all of this belongs to you anyway, so I want to share whatever I have with those around me. This is only by the power of the Holy Spirit that the early church did these things. So how about you? Are you able to share generously with those around you? Do you look for ways to bless others instead of constantly focusing on what's yours and all the things you want? We can learn from these followers of Jesus, and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, we can open our hands and say, God, all that I have is a gift from you, and I'm willing to be joyfully generous with everything you've given me. Number four, they were devoted to prayer. The Bible shows us that our prayers are powerful. Followers of Jesus were committed to lives full of prayer because they knew what a difference it makes. They prayed for those who were sick or who were in need. They prayed all the time. Sometimes it's easy to get distracted by our activities or school or our games and hobbies, but there is nothing more important than going to our Heavenly Father in prayer. Prayer is something we can do all throughout the day. We can pray in the morning, at school, in the afternoon, in the evening. We could pray at home or church or even in the car. It is always a good time to talk to God, and your prayers make a difference. We can pray prayers of praise, of thanksgiving, and also talk to God about our needs or the needs of those around us. God loves to hear you pray to Him, and every time we do, it opens the door to His presence in our lives and even in the lives of those around us. The family of believers in the Bible were committed to a life full of prayer, and we want to be devoted to prayer too. So wrapping up, we see that the church gathered together a lot. They shared all that they had with each other by the power of the Holy Spirit. They cared about how much Jesus sacrificed for them, so they wanted to honor him by being willing to give to each other. They prayed for each other and always glorified God in all that they did. I want to be like this in my life, and I'm sure you do too. Let's look for ways this week that we can be devoted to honoring Jesus through our choices, just like we see in the Bible.